Hi everyone, I'm Lim. The upcoming video is about review another thermal camera. It is from the Infiray. Yes, again, they have sent me another product, which some people already have reviewed it last year. Now I just got it, and I already have recorded a few repair cases with it. So the model is called T2S Plus. By looking at the spec, I don't have much expectation from it, because I will look at the refresh rate and the resolution. But very surprised that after I have tested the unit, I found out so far it is my best thermal camera. So for anyone who hasn't get the thermal camera, if you're looking for one, the upcoming video and this video will be related to you. Especially if you use it to repair the smartphone or any laptops, any motherboard device. Because what funny thing is, even some people have reviewed it that kind of like have different feel. Some people that even use the thermal camera in a forest, in a jungle, and then to shoot the wild animal. But you know me, same as a few videos before, I will challenge the quality by looking at the small leakage, 10mm, 20mm leak, and very tiny components, how is the response, the refresh rate, can it show up instantly without skipping the frame. Of course, that will be a long video. So this video will be short. I will do a little preview to you. So then, some people already own the 6 Compact Pro or the P2 Pro. You still have the time to sell it. So enough saying, let's begin to watch your video together. So this video is a repair case that I haven't cut. So I will be in here watching with you and I'm doing the commentary. Let's begin. This is a 12 Pro Max. Now I'm injecting the voltage. Now it's 3.8. Press the power button. It has a problem, 300mA, and then it drops down, high current. If we try to boot it up, it will be Apple boot looping and then it shut down. Original is supposed to be 100mA and begin to load. Now we are using the 6 thermal camera, 6 Compact Pro. This is the point of video. I will show you the quality of 6 Compact Pro. So remember how it looks, because next I am going to using the new thermal camera. Now I'm setting the focus because I try to get as far as possible, but I can't. This is the, you know, the farthest I can get. Okay, press the power button again. Now we see there's a heat in that spot. This is the spot that heat up. Because underneath there's a USB IC. Press again. So remember how it looks. Okay. By the way, the customer told me after he plugged in on an unknown charger, the charger not belong to him, and then the whole phone like freeze up and then shut down. So after he restarted the phone, it seems like stuck in the Apple logo looping. I think it is a common problem that maybe a cable problem or maybe the USB adapter has overpower voltage. It killed the USB IC that is from the motherboard. When the IC is short or half short, it will show you high current when it is power up. Some even worse, exactly like this case, it will suck into the looping. Okay, you turn on the phone, it will show you Apple logo and then you shut down. The current is so high when it is booting up. You already have checked none of the accessories that are causing the problem. Only the motherboard, it is acting like this. So you are sure one of the component, he might be half shot. So this is the time where we should use the thermal camera. So this is why. But this is not today's point of the video. Let's see the next camera quality. This is a T2S Plus. Remember the quality. You can see from a medium distance, I already can see everything's clear. Because without the temperature, you shouldn't have this clear. And then now I drag away like 20cm away from the motherboard. Because this distance, you can use it for the laptop repair, a big motherboard. You see, I can just wheel the whole board in from very far away. And then I can close up very close, even like 2 cm away, 1 cm away is possible. Now I'm just like 4 cm. And then I will go behind a little, 10 cm away, which is same height as the microscope. Now click the power button. Okay, I will click again. Look at the quality. Okay, again. See? Then, now I try to move it closer. This is the same height as the SIG Compact Pro just now. See that? Okay, the USB IC is underneath there. So the phone just now is a 12 Pro Max. If we look at the top of here, this is the place that get heat up. And behind, actually, it is this IC that is the problem. USB IC. But it is not the point of this video. I just want to show you, because without the thermal, without any heat on the board, all the other camera that fail to show everything clear. Let's say this is a resistor, this is the capacitor, they have a height different. They are like a city view, okay? Like a Google Map from the top satellite view. Once you injected the voltage, or maybe the motherboard has running a little temperature, then everything will be clear. This is what the most camera they do. But this T2S Pro, I am surprised, he can even see those without any heat from the board. So now we look at the picture again. This is a screenshot just now. If the motherboard doesn't have any heat or temperature different, he will be blur as the right hand picture in here. The right hand side is the SIG Compact Pro. You barely can see each connector and the capacitor as well. But the left hand side, you can see it clearly even before I power on, before it has any temperature on it. So that's the point number one. Without any heat on the board, he can show every object really clear. He can tell which one is higher, which one is lower. Hey, there's a shape of it. Also, I have to reconsider how I look at the thermal camera spec, especially the resolution. Because I believe different manufacturers that claim the resolution, they might have a different saying. They can say it is really high resolution, but is it only high when it is recording? But how he preview from the thermal camera is still low resolution. So this is what I believe. So the T2S Pro, the new thermal camera I will be review, is so much clearer than the video you just seen. Because I noticed after I recorded the video, I uploaded to the computer, I see the resolution, it is lower than the SIG Compact Pro. But by looking at the eyes, the resolution is much more clear on my iPhone. You will be surprised if I really compare side by side and you look at it with your own eyes. In this kind of video, it's really hard to explain this. That's why in the next coming video, I will use it to do a full repair, a water damage device, and compare P2 Pro, SIG Compact Pro to tell you what's the difference. For anyone just bought the P2 Pro, don't worry about it. They are totally different level, right? For sure, T2S, they are going to be more expensive. Some more, they are launching a new offer, some new modification, I should say a new accessory for it. By the way, this camera doesn't need any macro lens. You can just turn the focus. It can be very far, 5 meters, 10 meters away, you still can use it. You really can use it in the forest, you're shooting the wild animal, you're looking at the rabbits, no problem. Or you can use it as close as 1 cm away to look at which tiny capacitor is the problem. You can even do that. So this is why I so highly recommended this product, T2S Plus. By the way, before you buying this one, remember there will be an offer coming directly from the manufacturer. Because the manufacturer sent me this product and come with a new accessory. So I will do a proper review by then. And then they will launch a new selling price and with the new things in November. Today is October 26th, so should be in second week of November they will be launching this T2S Plus. If somehow you are watching this channel, below my description, okay, on the next video, I will put the link there. Or you can just use my voucher code. You can get the discount from the manufacturer. The link is directly deal with manufacturer. If you go to other reseller, it might be more expensive. Same goes to the P2 Pro for whoever bought it. I don't know how much the price it will be. By the next month, you will see how much you can get the discount and then you decide who you want to buy from. If there's someone who cannot wait, you can get the thermal camera now from anywhere. But what I afraid is there will be a difference. Because the manufacturer that told me there's a little change with a new accessory, a workbench. Also, they will be doing a big offer in November 2nd week, a big discount. They hope I can launch the video before that. So in this video, there won't be have any purchase link or the discount voucher below the description. So you're gonna look for it in the next video. So I see you on the next video. Bye.